today about water recycling. As an experiment here at Back to La Tierra, we recycle all the wastewater from our house. That means black water and grey water. Come with me and I'll tell you about it. If you want to recycle your wastewater, ideally you would be able to separate grey water and black water. Grey water being water from the shower, from the kitchen, and black water from the toilets. In our case, it wasn't possible. It's an old house, old tubing, and black and grey water leave the house together. If you can separate them, it's much easier because the grey water is very easy to clean and you only have a small amount of black water, which takes more effort to clean. But like I said, we mix it, it's being mixed here. It goes into a septic tank. I'm standing right on top of the septic tank right now, where the solid sink, the grease floats, and what's left over is very dark gray, brown, smelly water. That water goes into this filter, as we call it. It's a reed bed filter. It's about 10 cubic meters, filled with small lava stones. Lava stones are very, very good for this project because they're very porous and they're perfect houses for microorganisms. Well, this filthy water goes into this tank. Plants like papyrus, vetiver, and bananas are very good cleaners. So we put them in here. They have these stems transport oxygen towards the roots of the plants where all these bacteria live that break down all the organic matter that comes with the water into this filter. Twice a year, we cut all the plants. Obviously, it's very good for mulch for your plants because all the nutrients, all the leftovers of the organic matter, what the microorganisms broke down, will accumulate in those plants. This is very good to cover your soil with. From the bananas, we had a huge production this year. Bananas are also very good water cleaners. And finally, the vetiver, which we talked about in an earlier video as an erosion measurement, is also a very good plant to clean water. And I'll show you what happens with the water after this reed bed filter. When the water leaves the reed bed filter, it goes into a tank and then it's ready for second life in the garden. So you can use your water at least twice, which is a huge advantage, of course. This is the water from the tank. And it looks like this. Now, I had it analyzed and it's perfectly clean. I don't think you would drink this, but at least it's good for the garden. This reed bed filter is, I think, one of the best examples to show how powerful nature is and how stupid we are not using this more frequently. You can use your water twice, and especially in the situation where we are right now here in the south of Spain, that's worth a lot. Thank you for watching. Our next video will be about our dry toilet, another way of saving loads of water. See you then. Bye.